Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about binary operators. So what are binary operators? If you have an operator which operates two operands, you call it as binary operators. So we will see one by one. We have three types of operators. One is arithmetic, second one is relational, and third one is logical. First we will see arithmetic operators. So in arithmetic operators you will use the basic symbols which operates two numbers or two expressions. So here you can see first one is addition, the symbol used is plus. So example is you can say a plus b, so it returns the sum. Now you got an example here, a equal to 22, b equal to 5. So when you add this you will get 27. So this is the constant value given, and what happens if we use this operator? So it becomes, it adds these two number and then you will get the result as 27. Next is subtraction, so minus sign, and it the format is a minus b returns the difference. So 22 minus 5 is 17 is the result. Now next is multiplication. So you have an asterisk symbol, okay, no x symbol, it is asterisk symbol, a into b, okay, you call it as a into b, but the symbol used is asterisk for multiplication. So it returns the product. So 22 into 5 is 110, so that will be the result. Next is division, that is slash sign is used, no mathematical division symbol, it is slash when you use it in the program. So a slash b, okay. So here what happens, it returns the integral part, that means it returns the quotient, not the remainder, okay. So here 22 divided by 5, which is not divisible, but the quotient is 4 and remainder is 2, so it returns only the integer part. So 4.2 will be returned as 4. Now next is modulus or remainder operator. You can say the operator symbol is percentage. So a percentage b, it returns the remainder, okay. That means 22 divided by 5, you will get the quotient is 4 and the remainder is 2. So here it returns the remainder, that is 2. Next you are going to see is a relational operator, which relates, relates two numbers, or you can say two variables. So lesser than symbol, okay, less than symbol, a less than b. So it relates these two variables or two values and returns whether it is true or false. So outcome will be either true or false. So the boolean value will be returned here. So result for this expression, a equal to 10 and b equal to 6. So for this 10 lesser than b, it is false, so it returns false. Second one, greater than, so a greater than b, it compares two numbers and checks whether the first number is greater than the second number. Here 10 is greater than the second number, so it returns true value, okay, that is the result. Then lesser than or equal to, so lesser than or equal to, what happens is it will check whether it is lesser than or whether the number is same, that is equal, okay, it checks both, okay. If both are any one is true, that means if the number a is lesser than b or a is equal to b, then the result will be true, otherwise it is false. So here for example a equal to 10, lesser than or equal to 6, it is not equal, that is not equal and not lesser than a, so it returns false. Next is greater than or equal to, here a that is 10, greater than or equal to 10, here it is greater than 10, 10 is greater than 6, so it returns true, okay. Next is equal, that is equal to equal to sign. You can say meaning is equal to, it compares the variables or the values and returns true if the numbers are equal, okay, it compares the value and returns true if it is equal, otherwise it is false. So 10 is not equal to 6, so it returns false. Then not equal to sign, which will have exclamatory mark and equal to, it returns true if the condition is false, that means 10 is not equal to 6, then the condition is true, so it returns true value here. Then you have logical operators. You have three operators, AND, OR and NOT, okay. So this logical operator will combine two or more expression, that means you can say relational expression. Say you can see some examples here. First symbol is AND operator, double ampersand symbol used, and you can see A greater than b, that is a relational expression, and a lesser than c, so it is again another relational expression. So when you want to combine two relational expression, you will use any of these logical operator. So here you can see an example: a is 5, b is 3, and c is 7. Now 5 greater than b, that is 3. Okay, 5 greater than 3 is true, and a 5 lesser than 7, that is 5 lesser than 7, again it is true. So if both the expression is true, then the result will be true. Okay, suppose if the first expression is false, second expression is true, then what happens is AND operator will have the result as false, because AND operator checks whether both the expression is true. If any one of the expression is false, you will get the result as false. Okay, next is OR operator. You can see the operator used. Okay, you can say it is a pipe symbol, and then you can see the two relational expression: a lesser than b or a less than c. As it states, or any one of the condition is true, the result will be true. Say here you can see 5 lesser than 3, it is false, but still it will return true because a is lesser than c, that is 5 lesser than 7. So in this case, second expression is true, first expression is false. Okay, since it is OR operator, it returns true. Any one of the expression is true, it returns the output as result as true. Then finally, NOT operator, we already discussed in unary. If the expression is true, it returns false. If the expression is false, it returns true. Here you can see a equal to 5, which is equal to 3. The expression returns false. Since it returns false, the NOT operator returns it as a result as true. Okay, this is how it works. Now you can see some precedence of logical operator. Precedence means the hierarchy. If you have an expression containing all the three logical operators, then how it works. So first, NOT operator will work, second AND operator, and third only it is OR operator. Okay, hope you understood this video. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, thank you.